Barack Hussein Obama.
Barack Obama, born August 4th, 1961, in Honolulu, Hawaii. Obama is the first African-American to hold office as President of the United States of America. In 1991, Obama graduated from one of America's top universities, Harvard Law School. After graduating, Obama moved to Chicago, where he worked as a civil rights lawyer, as well as teaching law at the University of Chicago Law School. He began his career in politics in Illinois by serving three terms representing the Illinois House Senate from 1997 to 2004. Step into the
sun. There's more to see than can... The primary!
2008 primary election was special in the fact that neither the president nor the vice president were going for the job, so to speak. Initially, Clinton held double-digit leads over Obama, but due to a revolutionary thing called the internet, Obama was able to get people to donate just $1 to his cause. This was spread all over the world, but this didn't stop the lead. But I'll tell you what did. On February the 2nd, 2008, the musician Will.i.am released a video called Yes We Can, which was him singing the speech that Obama made. Everyone loved it. I'll show you why.
It was a creed written into the founding documents that declared the destiny of the nation. Yes We Can. It was whispered by slaves and abolitionists as they blazed the trail toward freedom.
So what is Super Tuesday? Super Tuesday in general refers to the Tuesday in February or March of a presidential election year, when the greatest number of states hold primary elections to select delegates to national conventions, at which each party's presidential candidates are officially nominated.
Obama won a large victory in North Carolina and a close second in Indiana on May 6th. He then took the lead and committed superdelegates. The results in those two states made Obama the clear front runner for the nomination, and he picked up endorsements from 26 superdelegates in the week after those primaries.
On August 27th, Clinton renounced her candidacy. This left Obama as the only candidate, making him the primal presidential nominee by acclamation!
Obama's use of the internet targeted 18 to 29 year olds, the age group most reliant on new media for political information about the election. Numbers have shown that presidential candidates have increased their presence and activity online. Obama's campaign was further strengthened by his opponent John McCain's comparatively limited use of the internet. McCain did not have the organization of Obama's campaign, nor did he spend a comparable amount of money on this portion of the campaign. Both opportune timing and usage of online campaigning gave Obama a significant advantage over McCain. On November 4, 2008, Obama became the first African-American president of the United States of America. He won with 53% of the popular vote, 365 electoral votes. The popular vote percentage was the best showing for any president since George Bush in 1988.
His first 100 days.
Obama stated he should not be judged by his first 100 days. The first 100 days are going to be important, but it's probably going to be the first 1,000 days that make this difference. Obama's White House has several accomplishments at the end of the first 100 days, include passage of the $787 billion economic stimulation plan, signing the law in the expanded state children's health care suggestions, such stuff. And the state provides benefits to 4 million additional working mothers, signing the little better job of law requiring African passing women. winning a brilliant congressional budget resolution for Congress and record as a dedicated minister in 2009. It's enough.